This is Salamancer, and I don't even have anything to start this game off with. It's just going to be a really exciting game. So do stick with this pink soldier here, because we are starting it off real fast. It is going to be Laser Beams, who have the tag Bud. They are in the blue right now, versus 90LG, and I still don't know what that team name means. Somebody's got to tell me in the comments somewhere. But 90LG, the 8th seed in ESEA Intermediate going into the playoffs. The first seed is the Laser Beams. And so you kind of know how this game is going to go just based on that, don't you? Well, you'd be wrong. Mousy takes down Dr. Donut Man on the medic right away and has not taken a lot of damage of his own. They have overlost Blinky. And it looks as if Mousy here, you know, taking a bit of damage, but he's still up, still helping cap this point. Eats a rocket there, but now Sean Bud is down. And so we are probably going to see a nice little mid-fight win here out of 90LG on CP Granary, one of the classic maps of Team Fortress 2. And we did have a lot of new viewers yesterday on XTV, so you know what? I'm going to try and make this cast just as accessible as humanly possible. So, of course, we're going to talk about how there is a sticky trap there. You saw those little sticky bombs that got blasted out of the corner of the door. You can kind of hide them there in the little doors they clip through sometimes. But that was Ben of Laser Beams. Ben trying to find somebody in a sticky trap, detonate them on their head, and destroy them, giving them a player advantage. Didn't work out because, I mean, when you're going through this garage on CP Granary, everybody knows to check every little corner, every nook and cranny, because if you don't, you're going to die. You're going to die. So when people make these pushes, they always check everywhere, and they're very, very slow about it. Usually you only push with an Uber. They're actually pushing a little bit before the Uber, but this is a good idea, as it's going to allow them to be in position just as soon as they have 100%. They could jump in if they wanted to. Actually took a little bit too much damage there, maybe, but they have picked off Sean Bud, and that is actually a really big deal, as there is now a one-player advantage and a bit of a health advantage here for 90LG as well. They're wrapping around the left-hand side, and actually they pop the Uber behind the blue team there. I like that little flanking maneuver, and we see more and more of it as we've seen Granary go, you know, progress through the season. But there you go. 90LG forces the Uber out of the blue team there, Laser Beams, and the Laser Beams couldn't even defend the second point, so they are now back on their last with two players down right now, including Lang and Pure. And it's not looking good for them at the moment. They do get those two players back up. They're still on the cookie cutter classes, but there you go. I Like It Rough has gone down. I forget who that actually is. I know that I know the player, but I wish he would tag up as who he actually was, because I don't know who that is. Anyway, Pure eats a couple stickies there, and so it looks like maybe just some overextension here by the Laser Beams, but really, well, you know, really good play by 90LG. They do lose their Demo Man, though, and so they're probably going to want to back up. Blinky, actually, very close to death as well. You don't want to lose that Uber that you have been building up for so long. So he gets back and grabs a health kit, going to heal up the rest of his team. Wait for Mousy to come back up. He really wants to wait for that to happen. No. So he didn't want to wait for that to happen. I'm an idiot. Mousy did come back up, but they're trying to force the Uber out of the blue team right now. They're going to wait for the Demo Man to get here and start laying down stickies on the point pretty soon, though. That's at least what I think is going to happen out of our red team. But they actually just walk a soldier on there right now. They don't have to worry about a demo laying down stickies of their own, and that could be a very quick first round win for 90LG. It is. Everybody from Laser Beams died there in defense of the point. So, wow. Already 90LG, the underdogs here, off to a one-round lead. And yes, this is going into the playoffs of Intermediate. Remember that ESEA has three divisions, Open, Intermediate, and Invite. And oftentimes, the winners of Intermediate will get promoted into Invite. Although sometimes there's kind of some controversy over that, because they don't always want to. They're like, yeah, we don't want to spend that much time playing the game. But you know what? We've seen some teams get promoted to Invite, like HRG, who is now already, like, fourth place this season. But here we go. Another mid-fight here as these teams get out to each other. Dospack, I don't even know how to pronounce that, does get a nice little equalizer kill on Ben, actually, and he's rushing around here with 20 health. That was almost a complete wipeout. Where is Sean, but he's going to try and sneak in behind, get maybe an ambush on the red team. People don't notice him yet, but there they have found him, and nice kill by Dennis the Menace here to take down Sean Bud. Of course, he knew that once that cap was done, they had to check for people, because they knew Sean Bud was the only man alive. They could, you know, press tab, and they could see, oh, there's only one of them left, and they kind of expected the ambush to come, so they just had to check around corners, and sure enough, they found that ambush, and gave him a little taste of his own medicine, and already, that's a soldier bombing in, gonna be dosed back once again, I think. He ends up getting taken down. Does he get two? He got two kills there. Sean Bud and Pure both down. That's a sniper, actually, and a scout, so Pure was trying to off-class the sniper in the hopes that they could, you know, defend against this Uber, and it turns out they won't be able to do that at all. The Uber's in right now. It's 4 against 3 here with the red team just losing their invulnerability after that Uber was over, but they've already gotten a lot of nice kills on it. There goes I Like It Rough, and we have three players still trying to defend this. They're taking down a couple players, but they're losing so many of their own. Seanbud trying to kill the medic here, and man, this is an action-packed game. A soldier now jumping in. He's going to keep trying to finish off this cap, or at least get a kill, but can Seanbud stay alive against him? Looks like he can, and he can't stop the cap, though. Dennis the Menace with the capture on the point, and this guy's going huge this game. 2-0 now. 90LG is looking solid. Let's check out this Ben rollout here. Ben, one of the players last season who was on Avoided, and last season Avoided was the top of Intermediate. I think they were undefeated, or at least very nearly undefeated until the very end of the season. It's like 15-1 or something like that. And Avoided broke up instead of going on to Invite, which is kind of too bad. But you know, there's a lot of ex-Avoided players all over the place, and they are insane. Ben, no different. But he gets taken down by Lanzer very quickly. And 90LG, once again, in on top of the medic. They are just pressuring nonstop here. Dr. Donut Man and Seanbud both taken down. They are going to try and knock out this soldier as well. And what a nice pill by Mousy. Takes down I Like It Rough. Pure, the only man left alive, and he's now dead as well. So, what am I talking about? 90LG with a huge mid-fight win. Now, do bear in mind that the last couple times 90LG won these mid-fights, they had their medic alive. This time, they don't. The difference there is that they're going to have to try and build up to 100% Uber again. They're not going to have that huge advantage over Dr. Donut Man, where, you know, they can get like 100%, Dr. Donut won't have an Uber. No, there will be a blue Uber on defense this time, unless the 90LG team decides to push in without an Uber of their own, which is very, very difficult and very risky. And wow, Pierre gets a nice little shot there on Dennis. And let me just show you how that normally happens. Well, actually, we've got some action going on, so we may not be able to do that as Lanzer gets taken down as well by Lang. But Lanzer did take out Pierre, so at least there's no sniper anymore. But what usually happens here is Pierre was probably standing pretty far back, and he asked a scout or something to come up and open this door. If you walk up to the door, it does open. So Pierre can be standing as far back as he wants to, and as long as a scout opens the door for him, he can actually see all the way into here. That's how he got that kill. Seanbud on the defensive heavy now, so it looks like the Laser Beams team has finally realized, oh hey, these guys are actually really good at pushing into our last point. We might need to turtle up a little bit. So they do have a sniper, a heavy, although it looks like the heavy is going to go run back to resupply and change spawn once again. But Mousy gets out and kills Pure somehow. I don't even know where that happened. In fact, it just kind of happened outside the door, so Pure was a little bit too far forward there on the sniper. The Ubers are popped for both teams here. Lang trying his best to hold off this push, but there is a heavy pushing in on offense right now over on the left side of the point here as Lang sees it. He's taking way too much damage. Not really going to be able to stop this, although he does get a nice kill on the heavy. That is halftime. Holy crap. 3-0 for 90LG. Luckily, we had a nice little short halftime there, so I can get right into it, and I can actually remember what I said before halftime. Usually, I can't, so there's a little bit of a disconnect there. But this time around, yeah, it's definitely 3-0 for 90LG, and they are looking so solid right now. They're now in the blue. They did swap colors, so you got to remember that. That is kind of how the ESEA League runs here in North America. They always swap colors at halftime. But Mousy going to start laying down some stickies once again, trying to kill his opponents. And this time around, he's getting pressured by a soldier here who may be able to take down the medic. No! No, he cannot just yet. But meanwhile, 90LG has lost three players here. A nice kill by Mousy once again. This guy is going huge, and he's going to try and keep his opponents off that health kit. But he's finally taken down by Lang, jumping up in the air and shotgunning him to death. So I did actually play a game recently with Lang. And actually, guys, Lang, I think, streams his Team Fortress 2 playing as well. He recently streamed him playing like 2 hours of TF2 pubs with a Guitar Hero controller. So you do need to check that out. It was hilarious. I don't know if I have the link on hand, but it was linked on Reddit earlier. Anyway, Lang takes the Uber, jumping in here, and this is like the first real mid-fight win for the Laser Beams, but they've got to be careful they don't overextend now. Ben's going to start laying down some stickies on the point, but he also wants to make sure he protects his medic here, which is why he's laying down some sticky bombs right next to that medic's feet. Of course, he can't hurt his own team with his stickies, unless they are reflected. Well, no. Even if they're reflected, actually, you can't reflect sticky bombs. You can just push them back towards the demo man. Whatever. You get the point. He can't hurt his own team with them. However, he can hurt the opponents, and that is actually the point of the demo man, the highest damage class in the game. That is why it is limited to having one demo. So if you could have two demos on a 6v6 team, or three, or four, people would do it, and it would just be insane. You'd constantly be stepping on stickies, you'd constantly be running into traps, and you would just constantly be getting your lunch eaten. by Demo Man. So they do only allow one, which is probably good for the competitive scene, to be perfectly honest, because look at that. Takes down that heavy so fast from a nice, decently long range. Those sticky bombs are crazy. And there you go. Finally, that is the first point on the board for the laser beams. But I do always say this, and if this is your first time watching competitive TF2, I will say it again. The point of having all these classes instead of, say, a sniper, a pyro, heavy engineer, is that you want to make sure you're maximizing your mobility and your damage. Because, yeah, a pyro and a heavy are high damage, but they're not very mobile. And if you can't put that damage where it needs to be, then what's the point of having it? So we do have a nice little mid-fight here where Ben takes a couple of kills here, I think, early on. Yeah, he's gotten just one, actually, but it's looking good so far as Lanzer, the only man left, eats a rocket there from I Like It Rough, who's gone at least two kills this mid. And that is another win for the laser beams. They lost their medic, so it's going to be about even Uber charges when Dr. Donut Man respawns. But at the very least, we've got Pure capping mid. Then we already have Sean Bud on the scout rushing up here to try and stop any sort of ambushes on second. They are hoping... Oh, Sean Bud not winning that little fight there. They were hoping to cap second for free, but it turns out they're not going to be able to do that. And now Dennis the Menace. Wow, this guy is just all over people's stuff today. He is anticipating every single trap, and he's finding them so easily. Lanzer gets kill on Pier as well, so laser beams are three men down right now, and they're going to have to back off to mid. That's what they've done. They're sitting on the midpoint right now. They're going to try and use these choke points to their advantage, but a scout has already snuck in past their watchful eyes on that left-hand side. They might be able to take him down. No! Ben has been killed by Dennis the Menace, who is on fire right now at 90LG with still a two-man advantage. Easily going to push here onto this point. They've killed Dr. Donut Man. They have an Uber advantage now as well. Actually, a Kritzkrieg, and I wonder if this has even been called out. This could be crazy. Let's find Mousy, because here's the thing. When you have a Kritzkrieg, who do you want to use it on? You want to use it on the guy who has A, the most damage, and B, the easiest capability of putting that damage wherever he wants. And if you charge up a sticky bomb, it flies so fast across the field that it is absolutely impossible to stop. So watch what happens. He's going to charge it up right now. Kritzkrieg popped, and he's immediately going to try and take down this demo. Doesn't quite manage to do it, but he's launching more of these stickies. No more crits, though. Doesn't matter. He's standing on the point right now. There's only two men left alive. It is I Like It Rough and Pure trying to defend against Dennis the Menace and Rep. And now Rep bombing in here. Where is Pure? He's trying to stop this. He's standing on the point. Can he get it? He actually can defend that. Pure, the last man alive from any of those teams. Kind of looking like a wasteland out here right now, but he will try. Ooh, I was going to think he was going to try to get out and cap that point, but the thing is that respawn is so close for the blue team. It's just right there that as soon as they respawn, they can pretty much be in position to defend. Pure actually taking the drop down. He's going to be behind the enemy team. I like this. He spotted a soldier and takes him down. Nice kill there behind enemy lines on Rep. Lanzer's down as well. Sean Bud and Pierre doing some crazy work for their team. Whoa, Sean Bud just ran over a bunch of stickies, though. Gotta be careful about that. But there goes Dennis the Menace and Dio Space D. D-O-D-D-D? I don't know. But there you go. Second point recaptured for the red team, so they are not in that danger zone of losing last anymore, losing another round. It is still 3-1, but they've got to push getting set up. Lang takes the 300 health overheal and jumps in, kills a scout with it. Going to help his team push forward and capture mid once again. He's going to go back to the laser beams. And then, of course, you see I Like It Rough jumping on top of these crates here, getting his nice little perch so he can use his high ground, not be spammed very easily by rockets or whatever else. Mousy laid a sticky trap there and did kill Ben Bud with it, but Lang coming in with the Uber. Blinky doesn't even quite have his Uber yet, so there you go. He just barely managed to get it in time. They have popped it on the demo to save his life. And there goes Dr. Donut Man, disconnected temporarily, and it was not able to get back through that choke point before a sticky landed at his feet, and he died. Kind of sad, but that does mean a big Uber advantage for 90LG if they can keep their medic alive. They do need to do that, though. Oh, look at that. Langa was up there trying to hang out on top of those lights and get an ambush, but he was called out by a scout, and then Mousy came up and finished him off, and Mousy kills Ben as well. Beautiful kill there to predict where Ben was going. He predicted exactly right, and he's now going to start jumping towards the second point once again. So it's another onslaught from the 90LG team, who look like they are in a good position to pull the upset against the number one seed laser beams. So the by the way, the laser beams, even if they lose this, they will still be in the tournament. This is a double elimination tournament, which means that whoever loses this gets knocked down to the loser's bracket for another chance to play a game and stay in At the end of the tournament, there's going to be a winner's bracket final, you know, between the two teams who have basically gotten through the winner's bracket all the way, and then the winner of that faces the loser's bracket winner. But loser's bracket winner has to win like two sets in a row. The winner's bracket winner only has to win one set in a row because basically they've already won the one set. You get the idea. So there you go. A nice little push here by 90LG. They've brought the heavy in. He's up to 50 health here, but he loses the medic. The heavy goes down as well. Once again, a nice defense by a scout. This time around it's Sean Bud, but he gets taken down, and the Soldier's just kind of dancing around here. 90LG brings it up to 4-1. Wow, they are so close. They can just taste victory right now against the nigh invincible laser beams. And I gotta tell you, how do you kill a laser beam? How do you kill a beam of... I guess you could put a piece of black paper in front of it or something. Maybe that's what they found out. They just found something that's really absorbent of the specific frequency of light that these laser beams are emitting. And whatever they're doing, it seems to be working so far. So let's just watch the midfight here from Pure's perspective. TF2 Celebrity in his own right used to play invite level medic. I think he's played invite level soldier too, and he is finally on scout here. And now sneaking around, wrapping behind the two remaining people from 90LG, going to cut off this retreat if they attempt to retreat, which so far they're not. Does get the kill on Rep, who just was not looking for that at all. And there you go. Team Laserbeams once again wins a midfight there, loses their medic, but they're going to have Sean Bud going for another little ambush position here, possibly. Or maybe he's just going to play a kind of a screening role. No, he's definitely going for an ambush. He wants to see who's naughty or nice. No, sorry, wants to see who is going to show up to try and defend this point. And it is a scout, actually, a soldier and a demo. Dennis the Menace immediately getting a kill there, helping with due space as well. I don't know how to pronounce that name, guys. I'm sorry. But Pure does end up getting a kill on Dennis. So laser beams are stacked up in the yard right now. That's what we're watching here. Ben in the yard with his medic and soldier. Sorry about that. Ben on the demo, man. And he's starting to lay down these stickies, trying to disconnect the opposing medic. Now, if he was watching carefully, he would have seen that Blinky is on the Crits Creek because you can spot the little yellow bits on the medigun there. So we're probably going to see a quick crit into Dr. Donut Man. But you know what? I think they did see this. I think they realized it. Oh, a crit rocket. Very nearly takes down Dr. Donut. Mousey can't find anything to kill, though. The Crits Creek has already popped, and they cannot get the kills here. So, oh, what a failure of a crit. They came close, but they could not kill Dr. Donut Man. Lanzer ends up getting a kill on Sean Bud, but now the Uber is popped, and so Lanzer died very quickly to that. A bunch of invincible players now coming out after the 90LG team. They're trying to save their medic at this point. They want to keep this scout down, and Dennis the Menace, who has been on a rampage this entire game, finally dies. So now, once again, laser beams are going to push into the yard. After having survived crits number one, they gotta watch out for more sticky traps up here in this choke point. A very, very scary point to push through, but Pierre jumps straight in after this demo. Does a lot of damage to him, and he's gonna continue to chase him all the way towards last, but he takes a scattergun shot, and Lanzer is now dominating Pure, so not looking too great for him at the moment. Blinky almost has his Uber ready to go, and that's going to be another Crits Krieg, but he doesn't have Mousy in position, so he's going to have to pop it on Rep, and he does. Crit Rock is firing all over the place. He does take down Ben, who had to retreat in the wrong direction there, but at the same time, Blinky, Dennis, and Lanzer all die there to a nice flanking maneuver from a soldier, and that is going to leave laser beams wide open to go capture last. They are going to get themselves back in this game, bring it up to 4-2 here in just a second, as Mousy's the only man alive for the next 5 seconds, and 5 seconds is way more time than you need to capture that last point. It captures so quickly. That is the problem with trying to push too hard onto that second point if you don't own it. You can lose that map really fast if you lose too many players, and that is exactly what happened to 90LG. They lost the last point because they didn't have anybody left alive to defend it, and it doesn't take very long to grab it. So let's see here. We're going to watch the Ben roll out here once again, as the laser beams look like they're still in it, guys. And if you were watching XTV yesterday, you probably know how the next 2 points go. But it doesn't even matter because you don't know how the game went overall. And frankly, neither do I. I didn't even look at the score on ESEA before I downloaded this, so I've got to check it out. Mousy there eats a bunch of damage, though, and that is a wipeout for 90LG. This time around, Dr. Donut Man has stayed alive. That means, look at this, 95% Uber right now, and they are pushing forward so fast. They've got to watch out for Lanzer. He is the only threat right now, and he's actually back in spawn, changing to heavy, so no, that's not even a threat. Dr. Donut Man will help his team capture this point, no problem, and they will push. Already, they're pushing into last. Let's get on that camera. Who is that? That's Lang, going to take the pocket soldier role here, defending the medic and taking the Uber. And he's done just that. He's disconnected this soldier, popped him way up into the air, taking shotgun shots at him, trying to knock him out of the air. didn't quite work. Lang ended up dying to Lanzer, and now Mousy helping to get some kills as well. Rep and Dennis getting some nice ones. Dennis on the sniper takes down Seanbud, and Pure not happy about that either. It looks like that attack didn't quite work out for them. When they really, I mean, they had an uber advantage, so they could have made it work, but it was just a good defense out of 90LG to prevent them from losing this game. But remember, it's still 4-2 in favor of 9-0 LG. I feel like LG, I mean, I'm thinking of pounds, LB, you know, 90 pounds, but I keep thinking LG should be that. Regardless, nice little push here, and Blinky goes down to Ben. That's really all they needed. They just back up right now and not even continue to push, which is what they should do, because now, like, everybody is alive except for that medic, so they, you know, they're going to get focused too hard. And that's exactly what they're doing. They're backing away. They're going to let Dr. Donut build up this uber. And so at this point, because there's a big uber advantage once again for Team Bud, a.k.a. the laser beams, our blue team kind of needs to make some sort of aggressive maneuver and, you know, force the pop or kill this medic somehow, or maybe take the second point even if they can. Because if they don't make any aggressive moves, then they're going to be stuck on last point defending without an uber against an uber push. And I do not think they want to be in that position, but it looks like they might end up being in that position anyway because they can't find a spot to really push through. So they're, you know, just laying down sticky traps here. This is a nice little delay maneuver, but it's not going to matter as Dr. Donut has the uber ready to go. Why aren't they pushing yet? There they go, now pushing, and he's probably going to push on Lang once again. Pure taking just a bit of an over here as well, and he actually takes some of the uber. It's always nice to uber these scouts because they can get so far forward so fast, get on top of the enemies, and just do crazy amounts of damage with that scatter gun. 108 damage per shot if they hit all those pellets. So they get some time down on the point. Pure just hanging out here up on the pipe, not even... he's trying to wait out the uber. Oh, he tries to get down and cap that point, but Mousy not going to let that happen. He was prepared for that. Nonetheless, a soldier still jumping in here and does kill D.O. That's I Like It Rough getting that kill. Dennis taking him down, though, so he can't quite get on the point yet. And now the ubers are even once again. Five players left alive for 90LG versus just four for the laser beams. But it looks like laser beams are still wanting to hold on to second here. They really need to contest this. They have a sniper up right now. Pierre, let's see if he can't get a kill here. It's going to be tough considering everybody sees him and is spamming away at him. But he's looking for this. Spots that soldier, gets a nice shot off, but doesn't get a headshot, so that's not going to be a kill at all. Nice headshot on Dennis, but it's not going to be enough. It's a little bit too late to really save the... Oh, nice, he's gotten a rep as well. That's a 2K there for Pure. Close range, sniping it up, but it doesn't matter. It was too late on those picks because most of his team is already dead. They were unable to hold on to the second point. And look at this. Dr. Donut and I Like It Rough, since they are the only men left alive, they had to back really far up just to avoid popping their uber. They do want to hold mid. If you lose mid... In a situation like this, where it's already 4-2, remember they are playing until 5 points. If you lose mid in a situation like this, it's so hard to recapture it that there's just not a lot you can do. So they really don't want to lose mid, and turns out there wasn't even a push through mid. 90LG probably could have tried to make a push, but it would have been risky, and they aren't playing risky right now. They are playing it pretty safe. It's worked so far. They have defended their last point a couple different times here. Gotta watch out for this jumping soldier, but a nice air pipe there by Mousy. Good air shot from him. Takes down I Like It Rough. Seanbud and Bed both down as well, and the ubers are popped here, but Blinky gets taken down by Lang. Nice jump from him. Dr. Donut Man using the rest of his uber to run away, but the rest of his team is still in here. Pure and Lang were trying to get some kills, and it didn't work at all. Oh, man. So Laser Beam is definitely going to lose the middle point now, because there's a bunch of players jumping up towards it here from 90LG. I Like It Rough is making the wrong decision. Do not want to jump into this. Oh, this is going to be scary. Now, Seanbud did manage to take down Mousy, which is a nice kill. And what a beautiful air shot from I Like It Rough. Takes down D.O. as well. Lanzer's down to Seanbud. These guys are going insane right now. How did 90LG let that happen? Just got out-DM'd by Lang and Seanbud. Those two fierce. Just beasted it into that middle point to defend it. And they single-handedly just saved this game for their team. The laser beams pushing on to second once again. That was crazy action right there from Lang and Seanbud. I gotta say, that's a moment of glory worthy by itself. You know, submit that stuff to the top 10, guys. Do it. do it. But Lang going to jump in here pretty darn soon. And the sticky traps, you know, getting laid down. But it doesn't matter when you're invincible. You don't have to care about those stickies at all. And there goes Mousy, so no more Demo Man for the moment. They've still got to worry about the rest of these players, though, as there are five up from the blue team. And they're going to need to get all those kills to get onto that last point. There's a Heavy now defending as well. Lang just going to start spamming at him. But from that range, it doesn't even matter. The Medic will heal him just as fast as he takes damage. Thing is, now Blinky has an uber advantage, so that push did not work out for the laser beams, and they are once again stuck defending that second point. I'm just having some allergy problems today. Yes, I started the shots, but they are not really kicking in yet. Who knows, maybe one of these months it'll eventually show. But yeah, that's kind of what I'm hoping for, is that one day I'll wake up and be like, wow, my nose isn't stuffed. That's so awesome. Anyway, Pure is looking down right now, and he does spot something, but he can't force the uber pop, or I'm sorry, you can't kill the medic, can't force the drop. The uber was popped there from Blinky, and they are using that to cap second, but look at this, there's a back cap going on. Who is that? Okay, Lanzer takes him down. That was I Like It Rough, and now actually Seanbud looks like he's in on last. It's just one man stopping him, and there you go, Dennis the Menace is down, so Seanbud gets the back cap as the rest of 90LG falls to the main line there from the laser beams. Wow. So it's now 4-3. This game is tightening up very, very quickly. And laser beams are looking really solid here. They finally found their stride, but it's still anybody's game, as 90LG is still playing fiercely, and they are still doing really well. It's just that one little mistake there at the mid-fight. When they lost to two players, you know, lost four or five dudes to two players, it really lost it for 90LG. This time around, they've lost Mousy and Lanzer, and if I were them, I would already be backing out, but they're not doing that at all. They are pushing in here. I mean, they've still got the opportunity maybe to stop this cap, but no, not anymore. That cap is going to happen, and Dio and Rep, both the soldiers just died. Blinky got taken out as well, and if Pure can stay alive here, no, he can't, but it doesn't matter, as Dennis the Menace, no matter how good of a dodger you are not dodging five really solid players here at the top of Intermediate. Not going to happen. So Seanbud already leaping out towards last here and sees the Heavy, sees the Demo Man. He even knows where the sticky traps are getting laid, so he tells his entire team, hey, let's just push in left side because there aren't any stickies over here. The Uber's popped, mostly on Seanbud this time around. He does take out Lanzer, trying to keep this Demo Medic combo stuck inside the spawn door area so that the laser beams can bring it up to 4-4 in like 2 minutes. What a round. It is now tied up at 4-4. Whoever wins this round wins the game and goes on to the winner's bracket. Whoever loses goes on to the loser's bracket, which I've always thought is kind of a mean way of putting it, but you know what? That's what it says on the ESEA website, so that's what we're going with. 11 minutes left, so this is probably not going to overtime, but who knows? Who knows? We're going to watch this mid-fight one more time here, this time from the camera of I Like It Rough, who's taking a nice overheal. He's going to jump up, try to knock down that scout, but the scout, completely dodges that rocket. As usual, 90LG's losing a lot of players, but Ben and Dr. Donut both down. I Like It Rough does take down that medic there. It's a nice kill, and Seanbud finishes off Ref. Mousy's down as well, so that is a wipeout for 90LG. Not good for them. And the I Like It Rough player here, I swear I should know who this is, because I've cast laser beams before, but I don't remember. Anyway, I Like It Rough and this scout now helping to capture the second point already, and that's going to put them in a really good position if they can cap it without losing these players. But right now, 10 health left on this soldier. Oh, and he eats a rocket and dies, so it's not too great. Pure and Seanbud now in a bad position as well. Pure dies. Critskrieg for Blinky. He's trying to catch up to the Uber of Dr. Donut Man. Remember that Critskrieg charges 25% faster, so it throws off that timing a little bit. Actually, Dr. Donut Man on the Critskrieg too. Both of these medics deciding that invulnerability is for chumps, and they want massive damage out of their teams. So there will be no catching up from Blinky. Dr. Donut Man is ready to push very soon, and Dr. Donut Man actually going to pop this on Lang, I think. Yeah, he does. That's Lang getting one kill already. Dio, that's a soldier down. Seanbud trying to stop the scout from defending last. 3 health left on Dennis, and he gets away. Thundering outside. That's how awesome this game is right now. Zeus himself is looking down at it and being like, yeah, rock on! Laser beams pushing into last point right now, but they have to push against an engineer, among other things. And there you go. Ben gets a nice air shot, but I Like It Rough ends up dying to Dennis. Pure dies to Rep, and Ben is still in here for some reason. He is probably going to die. Oh, but he does take down a rep. What a beautiful pipe there. And look at the dodging. How does he do that? He is breaking everybody's ankles here. And Sean Budd comes in to finish it off. Wow, a 2K from Sean Budd as a finisher there. Lancer comes in and helps take out the medic, Blinky. And now this could... Oh, I'm sorry, Langa takes down Blinky. And this could be it. There's a sentry over there. Dr. Donut trying to get some damage. He takes it down with the overdose. Only one player left alive on this point. And Pure is going to cap it to bring it to a win for the laser beams. That is about the closest game I've ever seen in Intermediate. There have been some close games, especially from last season, too. But, man. Wow. Okay, so that was awesome. It was pretty darn awesome. And if you'd like to see more action coming up, there's going to be more awesome games as this playoff season progresses in Intermediate and Open. So do stay tuned to my channel, youtube.com/FatMop, F-A-T-M-O-P. But also, check out XTV, because every single night we are trying to live cast as many of those as possible. The playoffs are in full swing, and we have casted some awesome ones so far. This one was no exception. So do hit the subscribe, the follow, everything that you can possibly do to check us out, and keep watching Competitive Team Fortress 2. It's a great little spectator sport, and I hope you agree with me.